In today's episode, we're going to look at Flashpoint Havoc, the new conquest for this week. Hey everybody, Doug Jankowski with the Grizzled Geek, and today we're going to have a quick one. We're going to continue my series of, I think this is 4 weeks in a row, of talking about the changes to the Conquest system. Today we're just going to look at the new Conquest, which is Flashpoint Havoc, and talk about it briefly. No changes have come along since then. It looks like the next change we're going to get will be on May 1st with 5.9. So we'll talk more about that then, but let's go ahead and look at Flashpoint Havoc, which in my estimation is probably the worst redo that they've done so far. Last week, Deathmark was pretty good. There were a few things that I kind of wish were a little different, but overall it wasn't too bad. Flashpoint Havoc is just awful. It's got very few redeeming qualities. So let's start up here at the top with the single time objectives. They're once per week per legacy. So right off the bat, we start with critical missions, galactic flashpoints, meaning any of your weeklies on flashpoints can only be done on one character. For a conquest which is based on flashpoints, this is just stupid. This was the worst decision imaginable. You want people to be doing flashpoints on multiple characters, shooting for those weekly goals, so why not reward them for doing so? So this makes zero sense at all to me why this would be a once per week per legacy objective. So really this needs to be changed to a daily objective. Obviously reduce the points to the daily objective point values and make this a daily. I'm fine with only being able to get the weekly on one character a day. That's fine. But this is just dumb, being only able to do it once. Once again, some specific operations. That's fine. Whatever. That's cool for groups that like doing operations, especially if these two come along sometime during the week. If they don't, that would be a bummer, because then they don't get the activities queue bonuses for it. But otherwise, not too bad. All right, crafting war supplies. We've seen this one before. You had to craft 10 to get this, and it could be anything. The normal war supplies or the invasion forces. Again, I wish this were a daily, not a once a week per legacy objective, but it is what it is. Crafting invasion forces, we've seen before. Now the majority, I believe all of the rest, operations. Okay, so you can do operations once per day per legacy to get the daily reward for that. Everything else is bonus bosses on Master Mode flashpoints, which on the surface sounds pretty good, except for almost no one does Master Mode flashpoints anymore. Only about 50% of those who do it are willing to go for the bonus boss. And you've, by putting the critical missions, galactic flashpoints, the quick one of which is the galactic conflicts, you only have to do 3 Master Modes. You've taken away the maybe the impetus for more people to do those Master Modes on multiple characters. So these, while in theory aren't a bad idea, having them be all but 2 of your daily slots is very restrictive. Essentially, if you don't do Master Mode flashpoints, you are only going to get your points on one character. You would have to really crank out the regular flashpoints or the war zones, because look, nothing war zone wise. You're just going to get your either win a war zone or compete in war zones or starfighter. That's the only way you're going to get those points. Do group finder missions, uprising missions, I don't know why Battle of Ilum is even on this list, but these point values are still so low that alone they're unlikely to get a character to their goal, you know, their 15,000 goal. You would have to be able to put a lot of time in it. So you have otherwise restricted this to people who do operations or people who are willing to do master mode flashpoints and basically quit groups that won't do the bonus boss. And, you know, either put together one through your guild or queue up, be willing to sit in the queue for 10, 20, 30 minutes, an hour, however long it takes to get a master mode flashpoint to run these days, and then find a group that is willing to do the bonus boss to get the points. So, and that's it. That's all that's there. That's all that's to this. After a week when, with the death mark, where they mixed in some unique things like tying bounty week into it, and just making it feel different than it did before, but still rewarding and still pretty cool. We went to one that's like, yeah, here, do operations or master mode flashpoints. That's the only way you're going to do this week. That, it just was, it's the worst one they've done so far. It's the worst change they've gotten so far. I mean, I would entertain arguments for which one was you think might have been worse. The Gree event wasn't great, but at least the complete Gree mission could be completed once per character per day, so you could do those points, you know, day by day by day, and then just do a few of these other things in order to make up the points. So really, Flashpoint Havoc is the worst so far. We'll see next week if Ratghoul Resurgence, how it looks. I'm hoping this event tied thing will be maybe a little more unique. Include some of those weird things, you know, weird missions. But we'll see. I'd love to know what you guys think about this so far. I had like pretty high hopes after I saw what changes they're making in 5.9 and then saw what Deathmark was last week. I was like, oh, this is gonna be okay. I can get down with this. I think we're going in the right direction. Then I saw this Flashpoint Havoc, and this one, the fixes they're bringing in 5.9 aren't going to do anything for this. They need to retool this one completely, in my opinion. But please let me know down below if you agree or disagree with that opinion, what you think of the potential changes we're getting coming forward. Overall, I thank you guys for tuning in. I know I've been ranting for a few weeks about the Conquest, but honestly, that Conquest is what keeps me coming back. Now that we don't have individual stories, there's only so many chapters you can do, so many times you can do the various flashpoint story flashpoints over and over with different characters before you just kind of get tired of it and you have to give it a rest before you do it again. So Conquest is something that I looked forward to week by week. That was something that I could shoot for. It was a tangible reward, a tangible goal. You know, they weren't great rewards, but they were still, it was a goal. It's like, hey, I can shoot for this point value. When I've done it, I feel accomplished. I've had fun running heroics or flashpoints or something like that, crafting things. I felt rewarded for what I was doing. This, I don't feel that way for a lot of them. Last week I had fun with Deathmark. I'm not gonna lie. I the point value still needed to be tweaked, but overall I enjoyed that week. It gave me a reason to do bounty contracts, which I hadn't done in a long time, and I forgot, you know, they are kind of fun. So it was cool to bring that element of the game back in. So I have mixed feelings on the Conquest, and I'm gonna continue talking about Conquest through 5.9. We'll see how the Ratghoul Resurgence goes next week. I'll do a video on that. The following week I'll be on vacation, so there probably won't be a video that week, but then we'll come back to 5.9 dropping, and I will do a complete look through what was changed, how it looks with the new changes, whatever the new Conquest for that week was. But all right, guys. Appreciate you guys tuning in. I hope you guys enjoy playing Star Wars The Old Republic, and may the Force be with you.